There are recalls all the time from FDA and manufacturers. It's part of the quality control process. But this year we've seen an especially large number in ophthalmology. Several things going on. It has to do with enforcement from the FDA. Now that the pandemic is over, FDA is doing more inspections. They're finding a number of issues at manufacturing. Manufacturing of products of eye drops is especially an issue because they have to be sterile in addition to being stable. So it's very important to have clean manufacturing facilities. It's also important that the bottles in which these eye drops are placed are also sterile or in some cases have preservatives. That's been an issue for a number of products this year. The eye drops had been recalled this year. First, I have to say that there have been no prescription eye drops recalled. And so any patient should feel comfortable using their prescription eye drops they've gotten as prescribed by their eye care specialist and filled by a pharmacy. The drops that have been recalled have been, to date, all over-the-counter eye drops, the kind that are purchased at a pharmacy or at a superstore or over the internet. If you have any questions, every product has a lot number on it, and you could contact the manufacturer. There should be an 800 number, or your pharmacist, or the FDA. When a patient goes to a pharmacy or a superstore and looks at over-the-counter eye drops, the ones that are on display should all be safe. That is, if a product has been recalled, it should not be on the shelf anymore. Of course, a patient can look at the bottle, make sure that the expiration date is beyond today's date. And if there's any questions, they can ask the pharmacist about that product. So most of these over-the-counter teardrops that have been recalled this year have been names that aren't quite so familiar. They tend to be store brands rather than the ophthalmic pharmaceutical firms, or frankly, some rather rarely known brand names. So again, they shouldn't be on the shelves anymore. Some people still have products that they bought some time ago. Again, they can check with the pharmacy, with the manufacturer, with the FDA to see if those are still good. A very cautious patient might just discard all those and buy new product, which should not have been subject to the recall. So you should know that infections from eye drops are very rare. The pharmaceutical industry goes to a lot of effort to make eye drops that are sterile and stable, and in the case of prescription drugs, that are also safe and effective. So it's very rare to get infections from eye drops. However, what we learned this year is that it can happen, and it's serious not only to losing vision, but in some rare cases that patients got systemic infections and died. So any sign or symptom or any use of products that have been recalled is a serious issue, and patients should take this seriously.